Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for the GRE. We have been solving math problems out of this book here, the official guide to the GRE, the third edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. Today is our lesson number 96. Day 3096, 3 is to signify the fact that we are in the third edition, day 96, we are on page number 301, and today we'll discuss the concept of permutations versus combinations. What is a permutation? What is a combination? Or are they one and the same? Are they the same thing being said in two different ways? Or is there a real difference? So here's what happened. I learned it the hard way. Yesterday, I learned it the hard way, the difference between the two concepts. Yesterday, I went to my hardware store, local hardware store, and I wanted to buy a lock, and the salesperson in the hardware store was very nice, and he sold me what he called a combination lock. He sold me a nice combination lock, and he told me that the combination code, he told me, was 987. It looked very nice, looked pretty decent, it worked just fine when he showed it to me, when he taught me how to use it, so I bought it. I came home with it, but unfortunately, by the time I arrived home with the bloody thing, I had forgotten what the combination code was. So I tried some things. I remembered there were three digits in it, 7, 8, and 9. That I did remember. I did remember there was a 7 and a digit 7 and a digit 8 and a digit 9. That I did remember. So I tried a few things. I tried 7, 8, 9. It did not work. I tried 7, 9, 8. It did not work. I tried putting 8 in the front. 8, 7, 9. It did not work. I tried 8, 9, 7. It did not work. I tried putting a 9 at the end. I tried 9, 7. 8, it did not work. Finally, when I tried it with 9, 8, 7, it worked. All the others did not work. The salesperson lied to me. He lied to me. He did not sell me a combination lock. What he told me is what should be called a permutation lock. Permutation is where order matters. Permutation is where order matters. It matters which order I put the digits in. Combination, order does not matter. Combination in order does not matter. If you're cooking a dish, think about a combination of different spices. Whether you put black pepper and curry powder and salt and whatever else you put, in what order you put these ingredients really doesn't matter. What matters is that you have all of these ingredients. The fact that you put salt and the pepper and curry powder and whatever else, it doesn't matter which order you put them in. You're just combining them. When you're combining things, order does not matter. What he sold me should technically be called a permutation lock. People talk about a safety combination. They buy a safety lock and they have a safety combination. It's not a combination, it's a permutation. It's not going to open unless you put in the digits in the right order. If the combination is 3, 2, 1, it's not going to open with 1, 2, 3. It has to be 3 first, then a 2, and then a 1. Then and only then the bloody thing is going to open. It's a permutation lock. The reason why people get confused between the two concepts is because these two terms, permutation and combination, the term permutation and combination, in our daily life, in our colloquial language, in our colloquial speech, informal speech that is, in our informal speech, we end up using the term permutation and combination as if they were synonyms. They are not synonyms. By the way, I put the word colloquial in capital letters because in the event that you're interested in improving your vocabulary, in the event that you want to learn, even though it's a very simple word, in the event that you're interested in improving your vocabulary, you will find the word colloquial in our vocabulary lessons. Just type in GRE, GRE vocab words, day 5. Similarly, not this word, day 5, we learned the word colloquial, which simply means informal speech. In informal daily speech, we use these two words as if they were synonym. They are not. Synonym, of course, is a noun. Do you know the adjective of it? What's the adjective of synonym? Adjective of synonym is synonymous. The pronunciation changes from synonym to synonymous. They are not synonymous. They are not synonymous. This is something what we learned on day number 102. Again, simply type in, if you're interested in improving your vocabulary, simply type in GRE vocab words, day 102, and you will see the word synonymous there. They are not to be used, the word permutation and combination, they are not to be used synonymously. They do not mean the same thing. There is a world of difference between a permutation and a combination. In permutation, order matters. In combination, order does not. For example, let's start out with something very simple scenario. Let's start out with three people. We have three people, A, B, and C. And we are to choose two people among these three for president and for vice president. How many different ways can we pick a person to be a president among these three people? Obviously three, because there are three people there. There are three ways. After we have picked a person for the position of president, how many different ways can I pick a person for a vice president? Two ways, of course. And altogether, there are six different ways. Six different permutations. I was about to say six different combinations. See, that's the problem. In our daily speech, we are not careful. And we use these two terms as if they were synonymous. We use them synonymously. But in mathematics, they are not synonymous. They are not synonym. They are not to be used synonymously. To a mathematician, a permutation is where order matters. A combination is where order does not matter. So how many different ways can we make an arrangement of two people, one being a president, one being a vice president? Six. Let's see what happens under the combination. Again, three people, A, B, and C, three people. Okay, watch what happens. How many different ways can we pick first person? Obviously, three ways, A, B, or C. How many different ways can we pick a second person? A second person is either a B or a C. If you pick B for the first, if you already pick B, we can either pick A or a C. If you started out with C, we can either pick A or B. So what's going on here? What happens is that because order does not matter, what happens is this. Once we have chosen A and B, we cannot count B and A as another possibility. It's the same thing. A combination is where, let's say there are three people sitting in the room. There are three people. Okay, it's like doing a combination is where you're doing a certain task. So there are three people in that room over there. I'm telling you, there are three people in that room. Can you bring me two people there to help me move a couch? Or you have three friends, and you want to go to a movie, and you just want to invite two of those three friends. If I want to invite only two of those three friends, how many different ways can I do that? Well, whether you invite A and then B or B and then A is the same thing. You're inviting A and B. Order doesn't matter. So as you can see, there is a double counting going on. So how many different ways can we pick? How many different ways were we able to pick first person? Three ways. Just like before, three ways. How many different ways were we able to pick second person? Two ways, just like before. But what happens is that by the time you pick a second person, you begin to repeat. And since order doesn't matter, you can't repeat. Once you pick A and then C, it's same as picking C and then A. It's the same exact thing. And similarly, once you picked B and then C, is the same as choosing C or and then B. We're counting everything twice. Since we're counting everything twice, this is where the punchline is. This is where the punchline comes in. Since we're counting everything twice, whatever different ways that you count it, we only can take half as many. We can only take half as many, and therefore there are only three ways that you can combine. Only three ways. What three ways? What right here? What three ways? A, B, and C. What three ways? You can either have AB or AC or BC. We cannot go around counting CB as another one, CA as another one, BA as another one. It's the same thing. But here it matters. It does matter whether you pick A for the president and then B for the vice president or the other way around. It matters here. Here it does not. So on the combination, there are only three possibilities, half as many as here. Whatever the permutation, if you're picking two people, then however many ways you can have permutation here, you're going to have half as many permutations here. Let's do one more. Again, three people. Listen very carefully. Three people. Okay, watch what happens. Something interesting is going to happen. There are three people, and I'm telling you, listen very carefully. There are three people in that room over there, and I'm telling you that I need help to move this couch for me, or I have three friends or three employees, and I need to have some a project done. So I, as a boss, there is a project has to be done, and I need three people to work on the project, and I only have three employees, or I have three friends, and I want to go to a movie with three friends. Well, how many choices do I have? There are three people in that room, and I tell you, go to that room and get me three people to move the couch. Well, how many choices do we have? Only one ways. There is only one way that we can pick three people, choose three out of three. How many different ways? Only one way, which is to choose all three of them. We understand that concept, obviously. What we're going to do now is to make a transition. Okay, listen very carefully. Is to make a transition from permutation to combination and understand how do we go from here, however many choices we'll see here, to a situation where there's only one way. Of course, there's only one way to pick three people out of three. Get all three of them, obviously. I need three people to work on the project. I have three employees. It leaves me no choice. I have three friends, and I want to go to movies with three friends. Of course, call all three of them. End of the story. There is only one way. Let's see what happens in permutation. How many different ways can we pick a first place? How many different ways can we pick fill a first place? Of course, there are three people. I have three choices, A, B, and C. Okay, understood. How many different ways can we pick a second person? Well, if you have chosen A, you can pick B or C. If you choose A or C, or A or B. As you can see, there are two ways. And finally, whichever person is left over, if A and B, then of course you're going to pick C, only one choice there. If A or C, or it's B, there's only one way you can pick a third person, you understand that. Three times, two times, this of course is six ways. There are six ways here. How do we go from having a six different permutation, six different choices, to a situation where there are still three people? Again, I'm only picking three. Here you're picking three out of three. And I had six different ways of making an arrangement, and it was permutation. Position matters here because we're talking about president, vice president, and a secretary. It makes a difference as to who is the president, who is the vice president, who is the secretary. Order matters here. How do we go from situations where we have six different choices, six different ways we could have chosen our president, a vice president, and a secretary, to a situation where there is no choice, there's only one way? How do we go about it? Here's the answer. Okay, listen very carefully. So you erase all of this thing. Okay? Instead of rewriting everything here, this thing belongs here now. What you see here belongs here now. Do you understand? Instead of rewriting it. So watch what happens. How many different ways can we pick a first person? Well, same as before, three ways. So far, so good. So So far, so good. How many different ways can we pick a second person? Of course, two ways. So far, so good. But because it's a combination and order does not matter, as we talked about a little while ago we talked about it, so I'm not going to spend too much time on it. Once we have chosen A and B, we cannot choose B and A as other combination. It's one and the same. Once we have chosen C and then B, we cannot choose B and then C as other choice. It's the same thing, same two people. We're counting everything twice. By the time we pick a second person, we're counting everything twice. So however many ways we had of choosing two people, we can only take half as many. Now watch what happens. This is where the tricky part comes in. So we have already chosen our two people. Our two people being, let's make a list of them. Our two people being, we have already chosen, okay? We have, the story picks up from here. We have already chosen our two people, A, B, or B, A. We have chosen our two people. A, B, A, C. B, A, B, C. C, A, or C, B. That's where the 6 comes in. And because we're counting everything twice, A, B, and B, A, A, C, and C, A, since we're counting everything twice, we have to take half as many. So two people are already chosen. Let's pick a third person. If it's A, B, I'm going to pick C. If it's A, C, I'm going to pick B. If it's B, A, I'm going to pick C. If it's B, C, I'm going to pick A. If it's C, A, we're going to pick B. If it's C, B, we're going to pick A. Now watch what happens. By the time we pick the third person, which is what we are doing here, two people are already chosen. We have already chosen two people. By the time we pick a third person, what happens? What do you see? A, A, B, C. A, B, C. A, C, B. B, C, A. Oh, there's a triple counting going on now. I see B, C, A. C, B, A. C, B. C, A, B. There's triple counting going on here. I'm counting everything three times. The two people, actually we didn't have to make it so complicated. The two people that we had chosen, let's not repeat this part here. We don't need this part here. The two people we had chosen were A, B, A, C, and B, C, B, A. A, B, B, C, and A, B, A, C, and B, C. Those were the three ways that we have chosen two people. As you can see, there are three ways of choosing because two cancels out. There were three ways of choosing a second person. Once we have chosen the second person, then if it's AB, we can pick C. If it's AC, we can pick B. If it's BC, we can pick A. But as you can see, we are counting everything three times. Everything is counted three times. It's the same combination of three people, but everything is being triple counted. Because everything is triple counted, then however many ways that you figured out there were of picking a third person, you can only pick, which is only one way. There was only one way to pick a third person, as you can clearly see. We have to take a third of that. We have to take a third of that because everything is being triple counted. Which is why, of course, we knew the answer from the very beginning, why there is only one way of picking three people out of three, because there is only three people. As you can, here's the math. Let's do a little bit more interesting. Let's do something a little bit more interesting, and let's figure out how many different ways can we pick three people out of four. How many ways we can pick three people out of four? Permutation is very straightforward. We can pick three people out of four. How many different ways can we pick a first person? Four ways. How many different ways can we pick a second person? Three ways, because we already picked one. How many different ways can we pick a third person? Two ways. 24 ways. 24 ways. What happens if it's a combination where order does not matter? Where order does not matter. Let's find out, shall we? How many different ways can we pick a first person? Four ways. Either A, B, C, or D. How many different ways can we pick a second person? Three ways, of course. If it's A, we can choose either B, C, or D. If it's B, we can choose A, C or D. If it's C, we can choose A, B, or D. And if it's D, we can choose either A, B, or C. Again, we see that as soon as we pick a second person, as soon as we start second person, we're double counting. We're counting A, B, C as one possibility. A, B as one possibility, and B, A is another possibility. We're double counting. We're counting DB as one possibility, and BD is another one. Since everything is being double counted, we can only take half as many. So it's four. Let's put it on the top a little bit so we have room. So four ways to pick a first person, three ways to pick a second person, but we realize that as soon as we pick a second person, you're going to start double counting. Therefore, however many ways that you count it, you can only count half as many because everything is being double counted. So now the two people have already been chosen. Same as before in the story, two people have already been chosen. We're going to make a list of pairs that we have chosen so far. Watch what happens. We're going to make a list of pairs that we have chosen so far. A, B, C, D. We can have AB. We can have AC. We can have AD. We can have BC. We can have BD. Or finally, we can have CD. As you can see, there are six ways we can make pairs right here. Six ways, because even though there are 12 permutation of having two people out of four when the order matters in combination, there are only half as many possibilities. Half as many possibilities because everything is going to start double counting when you pick a second person. Now let's see what happens when we start picking a third person, having chosen two people already. Keep that in mind, having chosen two people already. We have already chosen two people, now we're going to pick third person. So if it's AB, we have two choices, either C or a D. If it's AC, it's either B or D. If it's AB, it's either C or D. If it's BC, it's either A or D. And if it's DB, it's either A or C. If it's CD, it's either A or B. Watch what happens when you pick a second person. Watch what happens when we pick a second person. ABD, it's the same people as I need A, B, and D right here. Why do I have AB twice? AB, AC, this should have said AD, in which case this is going to change. AB, AC, and AD, in which case we have either B or C. So there we go. Once we have ABD, ABD is same as ADB. ADB, which is same as BDA. You see that? ABD, ADB, or BDA. It's the same three people. I'm counting it three times. We're triple counting. When we start picking a third person, we begin to triple count. Let's look at one more if you like. ACB is one possibility. But once you have chosen ACB, you cannot count BCA as another possibility. We cannot count, there should be one more. We're looking at ACB, BCA. ACB, oh there you go, ABC. Right here, ABC. ABC and ACB and BCA are the same three people. We are counting everything three times. It's triple counted. So how do we account for it? Well, the way we account for it is that we first count how many different ways we can pick a third person. Well, there is two ways of picking a third person. And then realize that as soon as we pick a third person, there are two ways of picking a third person. And then realize that as soon as we pick a third person, we'll begin to count triple count. Therefore, we take a third of the total amount. There you go. Now watch what happens. 2 is going to cancel out with that 2, this 3 is going to go out with that 3, and turns out that there are 4 different ways we could have chosen 3 people out of 4. There are 4 different ways we could have chosen 3 people out of 4. And if you think about it, it makes logical sense. Do you know why it makes sense? Well, of course this makes sense because we're going to continue here, okay? When I put a demarcation, that means we are talking about combination now. There are four peoples. Who are the four peoples? A, B, C, D. Who are the four peoples? A, B, C, D. Who are they? Of course, A, B, C, D. Sorry, who are they? They are A, B, C, D. They are the four people. And I tell you, to go in that room, there are four people sitting there. Bring me three to move a couch. Or I have four friends and I want to invite three of them to go to movies with me. Or you are the boss, there are four employees and you need three of them to work on a project. How many different ways can you pick three people out of four to work on a project, to go to movies with you, to move a couch? Well, there are only four ways. We just found it. There are only four ways. Why? Because the one possibility is that you go in that room and come out with A, B, C and decide not to pick D. Or you can go in the room and pick A, B, D and choose not to have C. Or go in there and decide I don't want B. Or go in there and tell me that you don't want A. Of course there are only four ways. Of course there are only four ways. Right here, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can either have ABC or ABD or ACD or BCD. That's the logic. That's the intuitive explanation. This is the mathematics behind it. Do you understand? Other than that, it's very simple. Let's do a problem. Again, permutation versus combination. We're not going to erase that. So let's look at problem number 7. That appears on page 167. Okay, it's important that the book is in front of you. I always take it for granted that you have the book in front of you. Turn to page number 167. Page number 167. Give me a chance also to turn to it. And on page 167 it says, again, make sure the book is in front of you. It says the manager is forming a 6-person team to work on a certain project from 11 candidates. So we're going to pick 6 people out of 11 candidates available for the team. The manager has already chosen 3 people. So 3 people are already chosen. You wanted 6, 3 of them are already chosen. So you're going to choose 3 essentially out of the remaining 8. So we need 6 people. We need 6 people. To work on a project. You see, you're going to work on a project. It's a combination problem. It doesn't matter what order they are in. Out of total of 11 people. They further go on to tell us that 3 are already chosen. So we need to pick 3 out of the 8. We need to pick 3 people out of the remaining 8. 3 people are already chosen. You need 6 people to work on the project, and perhaps the project demanded that you have an accountant on the project. Perhaps the project demanded that you have somebody who is into marketing on that project, and perhaps the project demanded that you have a computer person on that project, and there is only one person of each kind in your firm, so you have no choice in that matter. There is only one accountant in the firm, he has to be on the team. There is only one person who does the marketing, he has to be on the team. There is only one person in our firm who does the computer website designing, he has to be on the team. So 3 people already chosen, I need to pick 3 more out of 8. So how many different ways can we pick 8 people? I left no room for myself. I'm going to erase all of this thing. You have it in front of you one more time. We need 6 people to work on the project out of 11. 3 of them are already chosen. So we need to pick 3 more out of 8. So how many different ways can we pick a first person? Well, 8 different ways. Because there are 8 people. How many different ways can we pick a second person? Of course, 7 ways. But we know now that as soon as you start picking a second person, you will begin to repeat yourself. We can only take half as many. We can only choose half as many because we're going to repeat ourselves. We're going to start double counting. So thus, how many different ways we have of choosing two people out of eight? Let's pick a third person. After having chosen first and the second person, how many different ways can you pick a third person? There's only six people left. But we realize that as soon as we start picking a third person, we'll start triple counting. We'll start triple counting. We cannot count A, B, C. We cannot count A, B, C, and B, A, C, and C, C, A, B. It's the same people. We're going to start triple counting. That it doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way. So how do we account for it? We'll take a third as many. Just like before, when we were double counting, we took half as many possibilities. When we start triple counting, however many ways there are, you just take a third of it. We are done. The answer is 2 times 3 is going to go with 6. The answer is 8 times 7. 7 times 49, so it's 56 ways. There are 56 ways of choosing 3 people out of a total of 8 to work on a project. In other words, in a situation where order does not matter. Combination. What if it were permutation? What if it were permutation? Well, if you were permutation, there are 8 ways to choose a first person, 7 ways to choose a second person, 6 ways to choose a third person. So there are six fewer possibilities here. Why 6 fewer? We talked about it before. Because you double counting the second time when you pick a second person, and you triple counting when you pick the third person. Let's do one more. This time we'll do problem number 6 on page number 320. Turn to page number 320. Problem number 6. Part A. How many different ways can the letters in the word rat be ordered? Let's turn to page number 320. And the way as the problem appears on the blackboard is not what you're going to find there. Let's turn to page 320 before I start yapping. Problem number 6. It says, in how many different ways can the letters in the word study be ordered? Study. Let's start with something simpler. Rat. Can be ordered. Of course, can be ordered. Order matters. Order matters. How many different ways can we arrange these letters where the order matters? Well, there are 3 letters, 3 distinct letters. There is no letter that is being repeated here. So how many different ways can we pick a first letter? 3 ways. How many different ways can we pick a second letter? 2 ways. How many different ways can we pick a third letter? Of course, there was only one way because there is only one letter left after having chosen the first 2 letters. So there are 6 different ways we can arrange the letters in the word rat. We can order them. Do you understand? Ordered arrangement, there are 6 possibilities. Let's do part B. How many different ways can the letters in the word study be ordered? Again, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 distinct letters. If there are 5 distinct letters, and if order matters, how many different ways can we pick a first letter? Well, there are 5 letters. We have 5 choices. After having chosen the first letter, how many different ways can we pick a second letter? Well, 4 ways. Because there are 4 letters left. How many different ways can we pick the third one? 3 ways. Fourth one, 2 ways. And the final remaining one. That's how many different ordered arrangement, because there are more than 2 here. Ordered arrangement can we have out of the letters S, T, U, D, and Y. We can arrange them in this many ways. Oh, well, let's see. 5 times 2 is 10 and 4 times 3 is 12. So it's 12 times 10. 120 different ways. 120 different ways. Let's do part C. Problem number 7, part C. not sure if part C is in the book or not, or something I'm making up. Well, what I'm calling part C is actually problem number 7. What we are referring right now as part C is actually problem number 7. So here's the problem. Remember there were 120 ways to have 5 letters arranged where the order matters. Here's the next question. In how many different ways can four men and a woman can be seated on 5 chairs if the lady must sit in the middle? How many different ways can four men and a lady sit on 5 chairs such that the lady ends up in the middle seat? Let's find out, shall we? So there are 5 seats. And of course, order is going to matter. Order is going to matter. It's a permutation because it matters whether Michael sits here and Richard sits here or the other way around. Michael sitting here, Albert sitting here, and Bob sitting here is very different arrangement than the Bob sitting here and Albert sitting here. The lady has to sit in the front. So let's start with what we have to do. We always do must conditions first. These are known as positive conditions. If they tell you that you must do this, do that condition first, then attempt anything that they tell you that you cannot do. Here, there are no negative conditions. They don't tell you that Bob cannot sit in the fourth seat. They don't tell you that the man cannot end up in the middle seat. Well, actually, saying that the woman has to sit in the middle is same as saying men cannot sit in the middle seat. I'm not thinking. But there are no negative conditions here. They're not telling you that Bob cannot sit in the corner. There are no negative conditions. There's only one positive condition, which is the lady must sit in the middle. So here's the middle seat. How many different ways can we fill the seat? Only one way. Only one way. The lady must sit there. The lady must sit in the middle seat. There's only one way, because there's only one lady. How many different ways can we fill the first seat? Well, there are 4 men, so there are 4 choices there. After having chosen the first man to sit in the first chair, how many different ways can I fill my second chair? 3 ways, because there are 3 men left. How many different ways can I fill the fourth seat? Remember, the lady is sitting in the middle. There are 2 men left, and finally the whoever guy is left, the one guy left is he sits in the last. These are the possibilities. 4 times 3 are 12, so it's 24 different ways. 24 different ways we can make an arrangement of 5 people in the 5 seat where one of them happens to be a lady and she must sit in the middle. Let's do part D. Part D. Oh, I shouldn't have erased that. Order matters. That's the permutation. I'm not going to write down the whole question on the blackboard. I'm just going to read to you verbally, orally. 4 men and a woman are to be seated in 5 chairs. Just like before, the question is, if you were to do that, what are the odds? What are the odds that the lady will end up in the middle? So one more time, I'm going to recite the whole question to you verbally. So 4 men and a lady are to be seated in 5 seat randomly. This time we're going to assign the seat quite randomly, in a random fashion. 4 men and a lady are to be seated on 5 seat randomly, in a random manner. What are the odds? What are the odds that the lady will end up in the middle? Well, we just found there are only 24 ways the lady can end up in the middle. And there are 120 different ways total of assigning 5 people in the 5 seat. There's your answer. 24 is same as 2 times 12, and 120 is same as 12 times 10, so it's 2/10, 20%. There is a 1/5 chance, there is a 20% chance that if you had 5 men and a woman, and if you were to assign the seats randomly, there is a 20% chance the lady will end up sitting in the middle. I have more to say here, but I think I'm going to stop here and do the remaining one in the next video, because otherwise we'll be here forever. Okay, I'll see you tomorrow, and hopefully we'll end up having the same situation as before in the previous, when we made 5 videos on the topic of Venn diagram. Most likely we'll have the same situation here. We'll have 5 videos on the topic of permutation and combinations, but as of right now I'm not sure because I haven't made my notes yet. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? Bye now.